Brazilian rhythms, right? And maybe, is it okay? I know we're streaming, but is it okay if I ask people a little bit about their background and on what they know, you know, like what they, what's your name?
Mark. Yes.
Yeah, so do you want to just a very brief, just tell me what you know about Brazilian music or what your back, you know.
As I was saying earlier, I think before you got here, I'm a saxophone player, guitarist, mandolin player,
yeah.
And a little bit of fiddle. My background is primarily jazz and traditional old-time music. Before bluegrass.
Real quickly, you know, just a little bit of it, yeah.
And Karen.
Karen, yeah.
And I play guitar, and I've been playing for a long time. And I actually went to Berkeley and have a degree in music. However, I'm not a professional guitar player or anything, so it's really fun to get in depth on these Brazilian rhythms because, it's great to expand.
You haven't been to Brazil or?
I have not.
Yeah, okay. Nothing like that, okay.
I'm Matt. I do play hand percussion, but hadn't really played much professionally or anything. I played more recently with some friends at a gig now and then and that kind of thing. But I've always really liked Brazilian music. I've listened to the Bebel Gilberto's albums and, other collections I've gotten in various places. But I've always liked the rhythm. I would like to learn how to play it. I don't know.
Sure. Oh, and your name again is?
Matt.
Yeah. So, Mark and Karen and Matt. And?
George. So, I'm a drummer. Primarily a rock and roll drummer, but I've always been fascinated by jazz and Latin rhythms.
Mm-hmm.
Not listening to the Frevo, just watching the and just trying to understand the rhythms and feel for it. I was in Cuba for a bit of a trip. I learned some drumming down there.
You went with Dan?
Yeah.
Yeah,
that's fine.
I'm Amy. I like to sing jazz and bossa nova primarily, and some blues too. So, definitely excited to learn more about the rhythms.
Okay. So, Mark, Karen, Matt, George, Amy. Okay.
Good.
And how long I remember that? Hopefully, you remind me if I. Let me just say a couple of things about Brazil that you probably know, but maybe you don't. Okay, so the European country that basically put its imprint the most on Brazil was Portugal, because there were other people who went there. I think the Dutch were there at one point, but the Portuguese were the most important European influence. And so the main language in Brazil because of that is Portuguese. Okay, so you probably knew that, but people say, well, don't they speak Spanish too? No, they speak Spanish because their neighbors speak Spanish, so they might need to talk to someone in another country, but in Brazil, the language is basically Portuguese. Okay. And then the other major influence on Brazilian music is African, the influence from Africa, because they had slavery in Brazil. And so that's how the Africans ended up there. The history of slavery in Brazil was somewhat different than in the United States. And in many ways, actually, but one of the ways was that, whereas in the United States, the slaves were prohibited from expressing themselves musically, African, they could do church music, but they weren't allowed to do African drumming. Whereas in Brazil, they were. And so, that's an important difference. But anyway, but that's the blend that basically characterizes. And then, of course, there is some, native Brazilians, the native Indians, some influence from that as well, although, not as much. So, all right. Okay, one more thing. Brazil is a huge country. It's gigantic, okay? And it has as many styles of music as the United States has. So if you just as a, you know, a comparison. So if you think of all the different styles of, if someone says American music, what are we talking about? Well, it could be one of many, many different things. So in Brazil, there are many, many different kinds of music, okay? So most of them have influences which are, you know, African and Portuguese, African and European, and with some Indian influence, but the styles vary widely, you know, and the distances are vast, you know, from one part of Brazil to another. So basically, you know, you have your, the north, you have the northeast, you have the southeast, and you have the south, and then you have the central part of the country. And the most of the music that we're going to talk about today, but not all of it, there'll be some other things too, is southeast, because that's where samba, well, northeast and southeast. So the roots of samba are in the northeast, because that's really, that's where the slaves entered the country in Salvador, Bahia. Okay, and even today, if you go there today, it's like the blackest part of Brazil. You sometimes you could look around and you could think you were in Africa. Okay, so it's the roots of the of that mixture were there, because that's where the slaves entered, and then later at one point the now the capital of Brazil is Brasilia, but at one point it was Rio, and so there was a period when a lot of people, there was a lot of migration from Bahia down to Rio, and so they brought that mixture of black and Portuguese music to Rio, and that's kind of where the samba and the bossa nova that we know today was born.
Is Rio in the southeast, or what region?
Rio is southeast, okay. Yeah. Rio and Sao Paulo are like southeast.
Okay.
Yeah. But then there are other rhythms too that are from like the far north, and maybe we'll get into some of those. So I thought we would start with a little background. I think everybody, when they think of Brazil, probably most people think of bossa nova and maybe samba, okay? But I think to understand what an innovation that music was, I think it's helpful maybe to listen a little bit and look at some musics that came before it, okay? So if you look at the first page on the printout here, actually, you know what? I also want to go over some just really, really basic stuff that you might know, but maybe not, and I think it's really helpful. Most Brazilian music, okay, you know, unless it's like classical music or something, but most Brazilian music is counted in two, whereas usually North American music and European music is counted in four. So you know, where we would go 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, they would go 1, 2, 1, 2, you know, and that I think gives a certain feeling to the music, a kind of a sway that is different, you know. I mean, there are other kinds of music that are in two also. I mean, polka is in two, right? So, you know, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, feeling, and it's got some other, the African element together with the two is one of the things that gives it a special flavor. Anyway, so the basic beat is two, one, two, one, two, right? And then you can subdivide that. So each of those beats, the one and the two, can get subdivided. So that one, two can be one and two and one and two and one and two and those can be subdivided as well. You can take each of those main beats, you can divide it in four. So one, two, one, two. Ducka chicka 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 ducka. So one e and a two e and a one e and a two. So you can divide it. That's the way it gets divided. So, all right, that's the basic rhythmic framework. The other thing, I put down here at the bottom, the bass drum. So the basic beat is one, two, one, two, one, two. But there are variations on that, you know, that, like, for example, if you look at the first variation, the bass drum is, it says there, surdu. That's the name of the bass drum, okay? And all of the rhythms that the bass plays, the upright bass, the electric bass, it all comes from that drum, okay, originally. And so a variation that the drum, instead of just going boom, 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 actually, let me show you one more thing. Look at the top picture, staves, and you'll see that I have the two notes, right? One, two, one, two. But look at how it's phrased. Dut, di, dut, di, dut, di, dut. So that first note is short, right? That's typically how the surdu plays it. Dut, di, dut, di, dut, di. Okay. And then you have some variations here. Dut, da di, dut, da di, dut, da di, dut, right? Or dut, 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 dut. Those are all variations on that basic two feel. All right, so moving along, let's turn the page. There's an example of taking those quarter notes and dividing it up, giving, you know, for into 16th notes, so that each quarter note is four, and you can play it two ways. So you can play it da 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 like that. So one, two. Actually, you guys didn't bring any instruments, right? Let's give you guys some instruments so that you have some. I know that there are supposed to be instruments here. Anyways, did he take them away because of the?
What are those?
There used to be a bunch of different instruments.
Two tambourines, right?
Yeah, there's some things in the drum set.
There's a couple of tambourines on the wall. Right there.
Yeah, he may have just
put
something. Yeah, he might be looking for something. I think it's all hanging. More over here.
Okay. Last time I brought instruments for everyone, but then
it's right here in the bag.
Oh, okay. Because I saw there were so many, I was like, well, I'm going to bring them. Together. Take that basic two, right? One, two, one, two, and you divide each in four. If you just play it straight, it's going to be like one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, one, two, one, two. Yeah, try that. Right. So there's no accent in there at all, okay? So often in bossa nova, you'll hear that. This just, you know. Da, 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 da 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 da. So that's 16th notes. You're just going da 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 with no accents, okay? But the other way you can do it, more in samba, is where you accent. If you take a look at the chart, the first and the last of each group of four is accented. So it ends up being like, so go 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. So 4 and 1, 1 and 4 get accented. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. Right. And there's a way you can practice this with your voice. This is a trick that someone taught me. You can, everybody say duck.
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 Okay. A chick.
A chick.
Okay. Say a duck, a chick.
A duck, a chick.
Okay. A duck, a chick, a duck, a chick.
A duck, a chick.
Right? And then a duck, a chick, a duck, a chick, a duck, a chick, a duck, a chick.
A duck, a chick, a duck, a chick, a duck, a chick.
A duck, a chick, a duck, a chick, a duck, a chick, a duck, a chick, a duck. So 1, 2, 1, 2. A duck, a chick, 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 a duck, a chick. Okay? Right. So that is one of the layers of samba, is that middle, that's what I call the middle layer, which is that a duck a chick a duck a chick a duck a chick a duck a chick. So it's, you know, each 1 and 4 of each set. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, duck a chick a duck a chick a duck a chick a duck a chick a duck. Okay? If you go to, if you go back to the first page for a second, and the very first diagram, very first music there, three staves, right? And so this is an illustration of what I call the top, the middle, and the bottom parts of Brazilian music. So most Brazilian music, because it's so rhythmic, and polyrhythm, you know, I mean, it isn't played by one instrument. It's usually played by several drums at the same time, and or instruments that all of the rhythms that the instruments play, whether it's piano or guitar or voice or saxophone, the rhythms are all coming from the drums, and then they just, you know, you transfer them to the different instruments depending on what instrument is playing. Okay, but so whatever, most kinds of Brazilian music, they're going to have these three aspects: the top, the middle, and the bottom. Okay, so the middle is the 16th notes. Okay, which could either be, like I said, that, you know, straight 16ths, right? Right, or it can be that samba 16th notes, where you're doing a duck a chicka 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 duck a chicka, right? So that's in the middle there. Okay, on the bottom, you've got that 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. And then on the top, you always have some kind of a repeated rhythmic figure. And that is often like what, you know, differentiates one style from another. You know, whether it's the difference between samba and bossa nova, it's often that, you know, that what's up on top, there's a, you know, which is often the most distinctive. So let's take a look at, now that we did that overview, let's go back, let's listen for a minute, okay? I'm gonna play you an example of something called Marcha, which is basically march, okay? And we'll talk about it. I think you can find it in, you go to page 4. Okay, you go to page 4 in the middle of the page. Dun 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 dun. Okay, so let's see. Mm-hmm. States. So this is some of the earliest carnival music in Brazil. It's, you know, they would march in the street. Not, I think people tend to think of carnival as fast music all the time, but these really old carnival celebrations, these huge groups would march in the street, and it would be like at a you know, relatively slow, it was more of a march than it was anything else. Why don't we just try playing this? I'm going to put this on here. This is in four. You see, notice this is it's in four because this really owes more to European music than it does to African music, okay, or Brazilian music, I should say. So if we count this in four, one, two, three, four, da, 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 da. Okay, so, you know, this was one of the musics that was really, really popular in Brazil around, you know, let's say 1850. Okay? Pretty soon, you know, once the slaves arrived, it started influencing this music. So instead of this very square, you know, dun da dun 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 da, you start seeing you guys know what syncopation is? Okay, you have an idea anyway, the word, you know, when something is syncopated, and usually it means that the melody is anticipated or delayed or anticipated from what you expect it to be, okay, and it gives the music a certain kind of a feeling. So you will notice in the music that you'll notice things start to get tied over, things start to get anticipated. So for example, that variation there, dun da dun 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 da, instead of dun da dun 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 da. Now you're going to go dun da dun da da da. See that the way that it's anticipated, and it kind of carries you, right? Has a special feeling to it, carries you forward. Let's just try that. Dun da dun da da da. 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 So let's listen to an example of that. Boias frias, quando tomam uma espírita espantando a tristeza. It's a fast one. Everyone, try this. Cheers. Da, da. Yeah, everybody listen for a second. Listen where it is. Two, two, da, two, three. So these were the beginnings of syncopation in Brazilian music. Okay, so it just came from things like march, which was very European, and they started syncopating it. Let's move on to something else.
That sounds very European.
Yeah, well, but less European than the first thing, right? In other words, we're showing how little by little it became more and more African. So, which is interesting. Let's look at this this variation on page 5. There's a march, Marcha variation, And it's just quarta sangue criança. Let's see if I can find this. Check this out. So this is also, believe it or not, this is the march, Marcha. But it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So what we're doing, look what we got. If you know, one thing that's really helpful with Brazilian music, I find, is to make the ties, you know, don't look at, like, make them disappear. Just look at the rhythms without the ties. So if you look at the rhythm, it's dun da dun dun di dun da dun da dun dun di dun da, right? Dun di dun dun di dun da. But if you once you put the ties there, then you get this: 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2. So it's very syncopated, right? 1, 2, 1, 2. Everybody try that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Right? Keep going. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Okay. So now let's play along. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, so, yeah, check this out. So, the way this is constructed, right? So, it's even. I mean, in other words, it's just da, 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 right? It's not like a, you know, a Cuban clave where it's like, you know, da, 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 da. This is just ba, 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 ba. Ba, ba, ba. You only stop at the end, basically. 1, 2, 3, 4, rest. 1, 2, 3, 4, rest. 1, 2. We'll try that with it. 1, 2, 3, 4, rest. Tendency is to want to do like a Cuban clave, where you go like 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, right? Isn't that what you want to do? Because that's
what I was doing. Yeah.
Yeah. But this is actually, it's a march. It's just a march. It's just dun da dun 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 da, and they're just tying everything over, so putting all these, it's making it super syncopated. So it's like da 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 da, like, you know.
Why is it written 1 through 5?
I mean, because to make it easier to count.
Okay, because it's not in 5/5. It's not in 5/4.
No, it's just,
okay.
But there are five. There are five
strokes.
Okay. Right. No, let me answer your question. Because there are five strokes.
Okay.
It's a stroke count.
Right.
So it's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1. But it's 4.
Right.
1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So anyway, the point is, you could take Marcha or a march, and you can make it very Africanized, very syncopated, okay? Gets very interesting. All right, let's take a look. I want to go to page 7. No, I'm sorry, you know what? Let's start with Bossa Nova. I know I'm tempted to look at the samba first, but let's start with Bossa Nova. So, at the bottom of page 5, there's a basic bossa nova pattern, okay, which is, do you have a guitar here?
It's in the car.
No, not you, Karen.
Yeah.
Okay, but it's basically this, 1, 2, 1, 2, ba, 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 ba. You want to try that? So 1, 2, yeah.
That's what this is. One,
yeah,
and,
yeah,
and,
I'll show you.
One, and, right?
Yeah, so there's a rest. One, two, rest. So, yeah, so the basic, what? Oh, it's a pick in there, okay. No good. So, and I'm playing the thumb in that rest. I'm playing the thumb, but. Okay, so that's the basic, that's the most basic bossa nova pattern. Question is, you know, we're gonna see how we got that. Where did that come from, and you know, what else is there? Actually, let's talk about. Here you go. Let's talk about bossa nova a little bit and what bossa nova is. So, bossa nova basically comes from samba. So the most important thing that you can know about bossa nova is that it comes after. That samba came first, you know, in terms of musical styles. Samba comes first, and then comes bossa nova, and you know, so it, like most anything where you have that, you know, obviously if bossa nova comes afterwards, it's going to take a lot from what came before it. Okay. The other style that is important to know about, people don't talk about this enough, I think. Is something called samba canção. Okay, canção just means song, and samba canção was a style of samba. Basically, it was that phrase samba canção was used in Brazil during many different decades, many epochs to talk about different kinds of music. But it was always kinds of samba that were more geared toward melody and harmony. Than some kind of, you know, more frantic rhythm. It was the more melodic, the more usually slow. Sometimes it was slower, and so you know, so that samba canção. But the thing is, by the 19, you know, so samba was very popular in the 1920s, the 1930s, okay, 1940s. And when I say samba, I'm talking about the kind of samba that you would probably think of when you think of samba, which is something quite, you know, lively and animated and for dancing and so forth. But around the 1950s, I guess people, you know, the tastes of people who were buying records and so forth changed, and they got a little bit of tired of this dance music. They wanted something slower and something more, you know, more for listening. And the first music that really kind of filled that niche was a kind of, was one of the versions of samba canção, okay? But the version of samba canção that they played in the 1950s was very, very, how should I put it? It almost had no rhythm at all, okay? it was just like that da 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 da, and that was all. That was the only rhythm, you know. And it was just, you know, it had no rhythm, very very little rhythm to it. And it was just, it was kind of this kind of background music, you know, kind of romantic background music to in a restaurant or something like that, you know. And I think one of the things that basically, like, my idea about Bossa Nova is what made Bossa Nova so popular was that people said, okay, we need to bring some of that rhythm back, but not all of it. We want to bring, we want some more rhythm, but we also, we kind of like that kind of dreamy, lazy thing that was going on in the with the samba canção. But we don't want it to be like so completely innocuous. We want it to have some kind of character to it, right? And so that's where, you know, where the Bossa Nova came from. So,
is the, are the chords in Bossa Nova also unique to Bossa Nova?
Yes and no. So there were songs, there were sambas being written before Bossa Nova that had sophisticated harmonies. You know, that had sophisticated chord progressions, that had sophisticated types of chords, nines, thirteens, flat nines, you know, whatever. But in Bossa Nova, it became even more pronounced. But that's actually one of the places where that came from was samba canção. So the samba canção had these beautiful harmonies. It just was vapid, is that the right word? It's like, you know, it just, it had no taste to it. It had no, rhythmically, it had nothing going on at all. It was just this da 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 da, da, you know, and the and so forth. Okay, so that's your. Let's just listen to. I want to listen to another. Let's listen to some Bossa Novas and see if we can hear some of these things. Glasses. Glasses are good. Sorry. Oh. Let's see here. Bossa Novas. Okay. Here's one, basically. Listen to the guitar. See how consistent that is? Bossa Nova was actually many different things. A lot of people try to say, you know, Bossa Nova is this, it's that. It was actually a bunch of different things that were all. I'm gonna try that rhythm. Always listen to the record. Yeah. Okay, so that was the first step. The first step was, okay, we'll take that samba canção, we're gonna make it a little bit more interesting. And basically that's our bass rhythm, is that dun jun chin jun jun jun. Okay. Alright, now we're bored of that. Now it's like, okay, we did that. Now what? Okay? So one of the things that you can do is you can take, if you look at the if you look on page five, at the page six, where it says one measure bossa pattern but with anticipation. Okay? So instead of dun dun, you don't, you know, don't worry about reading the music. Just I'll sing it for you, and then you'll get it. So instead of just dun dun dee dun 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 dee da, what happens if we anticipate the second measure? So we go dun dun dee dun da dun dee dun da dun dee dun da dun dee dun da da. So we keep adding that anticipation, okay? And that keep, now it's a little bit more interesting, right? Instead of just dun dun dee da, dun dun dee da. By the way, how long is that pattern? If this is one measure, one, two, one, something, one, two. That's a measure, okay? So this pattern, dun dun dee da. How long is that?
It's two measures.
Is it? Let's see. One, two. Dun dun dee da.
Measure and a half.
One measure.
Oh, it is.
Yeah. Everybody say one, two, one, two. Dun dun dee da. Dun dun dee da. Dun dun dee da. Dun dun. So that pattern is a one measure pattern, and that's a really important thing to know, because that's one of the things that kind of separates that separates bossa nova from samba. Now, you know, what's going to happen is that pretty soon, you know, as soon as you create one thing, then of course people will start mixing it together with other things, and, you know, there are bossa novas that are more like samba. But the bossa novas that are the most kind of separate from samba, that are most distinct from samba, are these ones that with this one measure pattern, and it's, which is this almost hypnotic quality to it, right? Dun, dun, dee, da. Dun, dun, dun. It's not jumping the bar lines. It's just, you know. Okay, so that's a one measure pattern. So then if we add that syncopation. So dun dun dee dun da dun dee dun da. So dun dun dee dun da dun dee dun da. Is it? Let's see what I hear. Which is one of this. Esse Sol. Let's listen to it, and then we'll we can sing along with it. There we go. At the beginning, it's more broken. It's not. He doesn't fall into a pattern yet. But pretty soon, he goes into the pattern.
De umas coisas que eu não posso acreditar. Doce é sonhar, é pensar que você gosta de mim.
So you notice sometimes he anticipates it and sometimes not. It's kind of every other time.
Mas a ilusão, quando se desfaz, dói no coração.
So sometimes it's just dun dun dee da, and then sometimes it's dun dun dee dun da dun dee da dun dun dee dun da dun dee da. So try singing that dun dun dee dun da dun dee da. But the second, but then go back. In other words, only just do one anticipation, then go back to the so da da dee da 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 da da. So now, huh?
Seems like it's more.
Yes, exact. That's a really good observation. That this music is like pushed, is more in the direction of sounding like 4-4. And basically, I mean, these are like big, like overarching themes in music, but one of the things that's always going on in Brazilian music is this kind of back and forth between, you know, the 2-feel and the 4-feel, and which is it going to be and which is going to win out. And in samba, it's definitely 2. And if you listen to the samba canção, the 50s samba canção, you know, that like that, it's definitely 4-4. There's no 2 to that at all. So So this is kind of like it's a kind of plays back and forth. It, you know, this is like a it's two feel, but
it's a two measure pattern.
So now it's
yeah. So it's just like.
Anyway, there's a lot to talk about there as far as the relation to 2-4 versus 4, but yeah, I agree totally with what you're saying. Let's look at so anyway, yes, go ahead.
Just curious, in this kind of music, do they have anything like an 8-bar blues pattern where they go
Well, they don't have the blues because the blues is from here, not
yeah.
from there. But
I
yeah.
mean, do they have it? The, is there a
12-bar? Tell me about 12-bar blues.
Either way, is there a like every so many bars, it comes around again, or is it just not like that?
I'm gonna say that most, you know, there are many, many different rhythmic forms in Brazil. I mean, like song forms. There are things that have no set number of measures. There are things that have, they're like chants, like just chanting and things like that. You know, very folkloric stuff. And then you've got the influence from Europe. You've got, 32-bar songs. You've got, 16-bar songs, 32-bar songs. So, yeah. It just really depends on the song. Let's look at another rhythm, okay? So, but that's basically, the idea is that you can take that simple rhythm, that dun-dun-dee-da, and then we can make it a little more complicated by adding a syncopation. Dun dun dee dun da da dee da dun dun dee dun da da da, and you could even keep doing that. You could keep going like dun dun dee dun da da dee da 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 dee da da. You could keep adding more syncopations. Another rhythm that people associate with bossa nova is this bossa nova snare pattern. It's people often call it the bossa nova clave. But it's really not a clave. I'll talk about it in a little bit why I say it's not a clave. But Joe Beam himself said it's not a clave. But it is. But it is a rhythm that people associate with bossa nova. Let's see. People sonia. That's the rhythm that you're probably familiar with, right? Okay, so this rhythm, this rhythm can be played two ways. You can play it, which I like to call forward and backwards. I just made that up, but you can do it one way, you can do it the other way. So the one way is the one like we just heard it, that 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. But you could also start in the second measure, make the second measure the first measure, so you can go. Ba 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 ba, right? Instead of starting on the downbeat, dun two three ah ah da da, you can go ba 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 ba, 1, 2, 3, okay? And you'll hear both, okay? And To a certain extent, it matters. It matters the direction, but not that much, okay? If we were playing samba, the direction would really, really matter. Like, if you go in the wrong direction and you're playing samba, like, people, like, the music's gonna stop. Like, everyone's gonna stop, and they're all gonna look at you. They're gonna say, you're playing it backwards, okay? In bossa nova, it's not that. You know what I'm saying? It's not that crucial. It's more of a sound that you in the background. It kind of sets the mood. It's reminiscent of samba, and it comes from samba, but it doesn't have this directionality, like whether you go the forward version, the back. And as a matter of fact, we're going to listen to, I want you to listen to some bossa nova right now, and you'll hear the drummer. And he starts off 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, and then he switches to 1, 2, 1, 2. He'll switch right in the middle. Here's the 3-2, right? 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. So he'll keep that up for a while. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1. So this illustrates a number of different things. It probably illustrates that the drummer maybe was hearing this song for the first time, and he hadn't really it's quite probable, and he hadn't figured out which way would sound the best. Because that's basic. People ask me, well, how do you know which way to go? It all just goes with the melody. It's with the rhythm of the melody. Whatever the rhythm of the melody, whatever sounds best with the rhythm of the melody, that's the direction that you go in, okay? So probably what happened was he just, you know, the engineer was like, okay, rolling, start, we're going, you know, and he starts playing the 3-2, and then after listening to the melody a little bit, after, like, it took maybe, you know, a little bit, he was like, I think it would sound better the other way, okay? But here's the interesting thing. Did it sound bad the first way? No, it didn't. It sounded more or less equally good both ways, and there's a reason for that, which is that bossa nova melodies are not written with a super strong sense of, like, the clave, what I call the clave. By the way, Brazilians don't use the word clave. They never talk about clave, but they do understand patterns. They understand, like, direction, AB versus BA, and they just don't have a word for it, but they, you know, they. So what was I saying about the, so the reason it sounds equally good is that in bossa nova, the melodies are not conceived as being like, oh, I'm playing in this, you know, like this direction or that direction. In samba, does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
You think so? Okay. In other words, let's take a look at. I want to, now that we kind of, you know, dipped our feet into the bossa nova waters, let's take a look at samba, because I think once we look at samba and that you're going to understand this concept of what you might call, like, directionality, like, is it going for, is it in the forward pattern or a reverse pattern, okay? So if you look on page. Look on page 7. Okay, and if you look at the one, it says basic forward pattern. Just as a warm up, I'm going to do the reverse pattern, because what's nice about the reverse pattern is it starts right on the downbeat, and we as North Americans, we like that. So generally speaking, okay? I don't want to cast any aspersions, but usually we like starting on the downbeat. So look at the one where it says basic reverse pattern. And so it's going to sound like this. Da, 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 da. So don't worry about reading it so much. Just, you know, actually, stop looking at the music for a minute, and just everybody say 1, 2. Just count with me. 2.
One.
So 1, 2. 2.
1, 2.
Ba, 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 ba,
okay, so how about we split the group up? How about Mark, right? Mark and Karen, why don't you count? You count, keep the one, two, and you guys try playing this rhythm with me, okay? So you can start counting. One, two. Two. One, two.
Two.
Okay, good. Okay, can we switch?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Just wait for Karen to... You good?
Sorry,
you good? Okay. Now you guys count for me, okay? So, one, two, one, two. Good. Very nice. So this is the reverse pattern, okay? And then, so we're not going to play it yet, but I want you to just look. I want you to look at the paper, and I want you to look at what I call the forward pattern, and you'll see that it's exactly the same thing as the reverse, but we just took the two measures and we switched them. So if we go down to where it says basic forward pattern, you see where it says the first one, the first basic mm-hmm. forward pattern, right? And it's, so look at the second measure, right? So the second measure is the same as the first measure of the basic reverse pattern. You see that?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
And the first measure is the same as the second measure of the other one, mm-hmm. of the reverse pattern. You see that? So the two measures are just switched. So, which is another way of saying that this is a circular pattern. It isn't a one measure pattern. It is a two measure pattern, and not just like sometimes like in the Bossa Nova where sometimes it's one, sometimes it's a two measure pattern. This is a two measure pattern, and they're locked together. It's always A, B, A, B, or in the case of the reverse, you know, B, A. B, A, but it never changes. It just always stays, and that is essential in samba, okay? And which is a concept that they also have in Cuban music, which is where the term clave comes from. So that's why I like to say that samba has clave to it, in the sense that it utilizes a two-measure pattern, and it's got an A pattern to it and a B, and they're locked together and they keep repeating over and over and it never switches.
And how do you define clave?
So you can actually did another presentation. It's on YouTube. You can watch it. It's called what is it called? A Deeper Samba and Bossa Nova, A Deeper Look is what it's called. And I actually spent a lot of time talking about, like, I think five or six things that define what clave is in a general sense, okay? But basically, clave is this idea of that the underpinnings of a song, okay, are this pattern, okay? And the pattern is two measures. One side is syncopated, the other is not syncopated, okay? Or vice versa. One side is not syncopated, the other is, and depending on if it's forward or backward. But it's always this, it's kind of like, it's syncopated, back down to earth, you know, basically off the beat, back on the beat, off the beat, on the beat. And it keeps going back and forth, and it creates this, that when you're off the beat, it creates this wonderful tension. You know, you're kind of like, where are we going? And then, boom, then it lands, and it keeps going back and forth, and that's where you get the feeling of that music. Okay, so let us continue. Let's try to play along with this bit, this reverse pattern, okay? Because samba is some of the most sophisticated music. A lot of people, I don't think it gets, you know, the credit that it should, because people just say, well, it sounds great, but how hard could it be to play? But it's pretty complex in its own way. So let's take a look at this samba. We're going to look at this samba called Telecoteco, I think it should be on there. By the way, that's the word that the most often that you hear Brazilians use. I wouldn't say like instead of the word clave, but you know, more or less as a similar term is this word telecoteco. So people, if you people talk about the music has telecoteco, they mean it's like this. It's like A B. It's got, and it's one measure is syncopated. You know, it's got a, that's that basic design. All right. Now let's see here. Samba. Oops, no, I said it. Samba. Okay. Let's see. Actually, let's do. My telecoteco is not here. If I don't find it in a second, well, I'll use something else. But I thought that
Which page are we looking at?
Page 7.
Oh, this is what it says.
But I'm looking for an exam.
Oh, okay.
I'm looking for an example of the base of the reverse. You know, the reverse one, and I'm just trying to see where I put it. Yeah, I'll use something else. Let me see if I can find Manolena. Okay, so this is, a very famous Brazilian singer named Elis Regina, and she's doing a song by Ivan Lins called Madalena, okay? And basically, it's the reverse pattern, but variation two, So da 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 da. Try that. So da 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 da. Okay. So good. So do you notice how the first measure is on the beat? Bum bum bum. Right. Sounds like one. Ready, go. Bum, bum, bum. Right on the beat, okay? But the second measure has that anticipation. Bum, bum, ba-dum, bum, right? So, bum, so one, two. Bum, 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 ba-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Okay, so let's listen how that works. How consistent that is? It never stops. And now it opens up a little bit more. It's a little jazzy here, right? They're messing around, they're playing with it now, you know. But they're gonna go back. Okay, and you know, one of the reasons that they're playing around with it is that this is not traditional samba, okay? This is one of the many, many different things that people will call bossa nova, okay? You could also call this MPB, MPB, Música Popular Brasileira, okay? But it's, you know, a lot of people will say, well, this is bossa nova. It's samba, but there's also jazz, and they're also playing around with it, too. They're not, you know, but the thing is that basic pattern, even though they don't necessarily keep, you know, that dun 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 dun, but even though they're pretty consistent, right? They keep playing that consistently for a long time. But even when they leave it, they never turn the beat around. They never, it's always in their mind, they're always hearing that. They can play with it, but in their mind, that bum 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 is always going. Okay? And you can't, you're not allowed to turn it around.
It's like a metronome, kind of. It's like a fancy metronome.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. In their heads.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Okay. How are you doing on time?
10 minutes.
10 more minutes? Yeah. Okay. So let's take a look at the other pattern. I mean, I find that the real samba is probably the hardest pattern for people to grasp, because it starts with an, like I said, it always starts with an anticipation. And, you know, and as North Americans, we tend to not be real familiar with that. Okay. But it's really, it's exactly what we just played, but instead of starting with basically if you start with the second pattern and then do 2-1-2-1-2, you get you'll end up with this. So let's take a look at, do you want to try playing it without the music first? Let's just try it. So let's see. Let's do the same thing. How about, George? Right? No, I mean, sorry.
Matt.
Mark and Matt, right? Yeah, okay. Matt, Matt, you and Karen, you can do our 2-1-2-1-2. Great, okay. Why don't you guys switch? Like, you guys count, okay? And then you can try it. So, 1, 2. 1, 2. 1, 2.
1, 2. 1, 2. 1, 2. 1, 2. 1, 2. 1, 2. 1, 2. 1, 2. 1, 2. 1, 2.
Exactly.
1, 2.
Okay, good, great. And now, so what have we got there? We've got that. What we're doing right now is what I call the bottom of Brazilian music, and the top, right? So we've got the bottom and the top. The 1-2 is the bottom, and that is the rhythm is the top. And then what's missing, do we have a shaker?
Yeah.
So what's missing is the middle, which is... So this is all I'm doing is going, you know, 1-2-3-4, 1-2-3-4, 1-2-3, but I'm accenting, I'm going, 4-1-2-3, 4-1-2-3, 4-1-2-3, 4-1-2-3. See how I'm throwing my hand back? You want to try that? Put the trombone player on the spot here. Yeah, just play 16, any kind of 16ths. Any kind of 16th is fine, yeah. But try to keep them even. Try to keep them as even as possible. Chukka, 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 chukka. Yeah, okay? Everybody count with me. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Want to try this, Karen?
1, 2.
So you see how that the first measure is off the beat, right? Da 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 da, and then the second one, bum bum bum, right? It's just like really, you know, bum bum bum. It really lands, okay? And that's the essence of samba. It's just this off the beat, on the beat, off the beat, on the beat, okay? Let's listen to some music and play along with that. So how about do acabou so. play fast, so it's like bop, 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 da, bop, bop, bop. It's hard to, sorry it's not louder, but. Everybody count with me there. One, two, count one, two. One, two, one, two, one, two, one. Yeah, but listen to the, tap your foot. Just start by tapping your foot. Now, one, one, two, one, two. Count. Two, one, two, one, two, one, two, one, two. See how hard that is?
Yes.
It's hard, right?
Yes.
Just tap your foot. One, two, one, two, one, two. Say it. Two, one, two, one, two, one, two, one, two. Just start by tapping your foot. So think of it this way. You get to rest. One measure you're working, then second measure you get to rest. So it's like bop, 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 ba-da, bum, bum, bum. So in the second measure, there's a little space afterwards, right? Bum, bum, bum. And then you start again. But don't wait too long, because you got that anticipation. One, okay. One, two, one, two, two, two. Essa não é a primeira vez que você me aborrece. Me depois com cara de santa, me aparece me pedindo perdão. Se me pedir goiabar, isso não se faz. Eu vou lhe mandar embora para nunca mais. Essa não é a primeira vez que você me aborrece. Me depois com cara de santa, me aparece me pedindo perdão. So when you know the reverse pattern, I put it here because it does get used, it does exist. But the pattern that is most associated with samba is this forward pattern, is the one with the anticipation at the beginning. and it's the hardest to play, but it also has the, like, you know, the coolest feeling to it, right? It's very swinging. And what's nice is that that's the basic pattern, right? That one, two, bop, 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 beat up, bop, 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 right? But once you get used to that pattern, once you know it, then you could start to do variations on it. So for example, there's, you know, that bump, 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 it's very, you know, very simple, right? You could go like bump, 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 beat up, bump, 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 beat up, bump, bump. So you could add a, like, an anticipation before the anticipation. Go bum 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 be dum bum 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 be da 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 da, or bum 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 be dum bum bum be da bum 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 be da 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 da, you know. So there are a lot of variations that you can, you know, but that basic, like, you know, you can spend a lot of time just listening to, put on a samba record, right? By the way, okay, you want to know, like, okay, who should you listen to? You want to listen to some samba. Yeah. So in the back, on page 9, so I made a discography for you, okay?
Thank you.
And yeah, and so, and if you want to know which, so most of the sambas, I think, are on the back page.